yet I didn't get a scratch. The last thing that I was saved me fight.
There were plenty of black churches that did not participate in the civil rights movement. They were afraid to be a part of it. They worried that their churches would be the next to be bombed. And so they refused to allow the leaders of the civil rights movement to even have services there.
Oh. Do a lot of judging of the ethnic color. You'll get your church blown up. You'll get your head shut off. But I often wonder what could have been if there was full unity. If there was a complete engagement, a total commitment of every black denomination, could we have gone much further?
Again, it's about terrorism coming at black people, I suppose. And when the black church, at its best, is the public face of the witness of love and justice, it will be targeted.
At least 30 black churches throughout the South have been destroyed. Churchgoers are still in shock that anyone could be so bold.
Church burnings in the 20th and 21st centuries provide the same message that church burnings in the 1800s provided. These church burnings are a way to reinforce white supremacy. If you are black, there is no safe space.
Bombing of this Birmingham, Alabama church claimed the lives of four little girls attending Sunday school.
In the Baptist Church in Birmingham, Alabama, the Sunday school lesson is from Matthew. I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you. Then a bomb blows up under the church steps.
The tragic bombing of the 16th Street Baptist Church in 1963 was emblematic of the savage violence that targeted black churches long before the Civil War. In meeting that terror with faith, organization, and determination, African Americans proved they would prevail.
Sanitation workers striking in Memphis, who were demanding the
inside of that, he talked about there are a lot of people that want honey and milk over yonder, but people need some bread down here. And he was very clear that night. He was challenging the church.
It's all right to talk about streets flowing with milk and honey, but God has commanded us to be concerned about the slums down here and his children who can't eat 3 square meals a day.